Arlington Wetland is what we call a constructed wetland. It's a wetland that council have built to protect Wallis Lake and Piper's Bay. Our community have told us that the environment is one of the number one reasons why they love where they live, and that's why we love where we live. Council undertake a number of initiatives in urban areas to protect the quality of water and the health of Wallis Lake. When a new development is presented to council, council consider the application very carefully to make sure that any new development doesn't have any new impacts on the lake. Rainfall contains nitrogen. Nitrogen is a nutrient that naturally occurs in rainfall, and in a natural landscape that nitrogen would have soaked into the ground and the plants on the surface would have used up that nitrogen. Now what we've done in our urban landscape is we've changed it completely. We've introduced all of these hard surfaces like roofs and driveways and roads, and now water, when it rains, runs off very quickly from those hard surfaces and transports that nitrogen into our estuaries. So when water runs off of our hard surfaces, it collects other pollutants like petrochemicals and sediments, and also gross pollutants like marine debris. Now, nitrogen is one of those nutrients that fuels algal blooms in our estuaries. And what we want to do is reduce the amount of nitrogen entering estuaries, because we don't want an excess amount of algae growing. We chose this location in South Forster to build this constructed wetland because the scientists told us that the area that this water flows into, Piper's Bay in Wallis Lake, is under stress. So what we want to do is include projects in this area so that we can improve the water quality and the estuary health.
The wetland receives stormwater runoff from 7.1 hectares of the surrounding residential area, including Arlington Place, Tahiti Avenue and the Lakes Way Road Reserves. So this is where the water comes in, the speed of the water slows down, and larger sediments and litter actually drop out of the system to the bottom of the concrete structure, which we can then clean out periodically to remove that sediment. Now the forebay is actually designed so when we get a high flow rainfall event, it'll actually overtop, and excess water will actually flow out here through this vegetated high flow bypass. That's to avoid the stormwater drains backing up and flooding of the existing reserve. As you can see to our left, another stormwater pipe, a head wall. So from that point there, the water actually diverts underground through to the main body of the wetland basin. And this is where all the filtering process takes place. So the wetland plants actually absorb the nutrients in the water through their roots and the stems, and eventually the water makes its way through around, exits through a pipe, back down the system and discharges back into the external water course. The construction side of the project is all completed. Some additional work, we're actually putting in some interpretive signage over towards the entrance to the system, which just explains to people walking through their site how the wetland actually functions. And long term, the site is still in the early stages of establishment. So over the next 6 to 12 months, we'll see the vegetation really start to mature and increase the water buffering capacity of the plants in the system, and also improve the visual aspect of the site for people driving by and walking through the site. It's exciting to see a transformation of the site from what it used to be as a pretty unloved grassy paddock with a shallow stormwater drain running through the centre of it. So it's been really pleasing to see the project through from start to finish.
So I really love this project because once it all grows up and it becomes a highly functioning wetland, it'll be not only a water quality outcome for our estuary, but a great showpiece as you drive into town from the south. The other thing that I love about this wetland is it gives me a chance to chat to my daughter, my four-year-old, as I drive into work about how important it is to look after our waterways. We know that projects like this one are working because each year we release a report card on estuary health. Now, since we started releasing a report card in 2011, the grade for Piper's Bay has been a B grade. And despite the fact that we're continuing to increase development in this catchment, we have been able to maintain that grade. So that's an excellent result.